So before we get out of here today, there was, you know, I'm not going to call it Browns news. We'll call it more like the media just starting crap about the Browns again this week. Obviously, Aaron Rodgers, a ton of talk ever since the draft about him wanting out. And people are saying the Browns should trade for him. We kind of had this talk with Deshaun Watson earlier in the offseason. And so I think you'll be a little bit surprised where I stand this time on this argument.
And it was an argument.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think we had a little back and forth.
I don't think Zach was here for that either.
No, he wasn't.
Neither was the statue. So at least somebody's stepping in for this one.
I'll let you guys go. What do you think? I saw a proposed trade where the Browns gave up. I think it was Baker, yep. David Njoku, and then what, a first and a second or two firsts?
Yep,
two
so firsts. 2022 first-round pick, 2023 first-round pick.
And then we got, what, Aaron Rodgers, and then didn't we get somebody else?
I wanted to say it was Eric Stokes.
Was it Stokes? Was it Justin Jackson? It was a corner. Yeah, I can't remember. I know it was a Jackson. I can't remember the first name.
So what do you guys think? I mean, should we trade for Aaron Rodgers in this year?
Aaron Rodgers, just for the record, is a stud. The guy is probably the most accurate, well, let's say, as far as touchdown to interception ratio, he's the best to ever do it. He's coming off a 50 touchdown to, what, 5 interception season?
Something ridiculous.
MVP season. The guy is an absolute stud. In saying that, I kind of think you stick with Baker.
Look who changed his tune this week.
Yeah. Well, no. It's not that I changed my tune. I'm just, for argument's sake, I like just getting you guys riled up at like 8 o'clock in the morning. You know, I'm still wide awake.
It's
I'm just
about 8 o'clock
work.
In the morning now. What are you doing?
Yeah. But, I'm always a loyal to the soil guy. I feel like Baker earned his chance. For me, don't get me wrong, I think the playbook opens up big time if you bring Aaron Rodgers in. I think it gives you a complete different dynamic of what you can do. But in saying that, you know, Baker's our guy. He deserves an opportunity to see what he can do with this team. And then the future's bright with Baker.
That's my thing is I don't see any reason whatsoever to mortgage the future for something that we don't need to mortgage it for. Like Baker is already, he's shown us that he can win a Super Bowl with the Browns. He can lead the Browns to a Super Bowl, and he can win a Super Bowl. We just need the players around him. We've already got the O-line. We've got the running backs. We've got the receiving core. We just need a defense last year, and who knows what we could have done. And the way he progressed through Stefanski's offense from, you know, having 3 head coaches before this in 2 years, and then coming into a whole new system, learning it over Zoom. I mean, it was an absolute nightmare last year scenario. And he excelled. I mean, by the end of the year, his progression was like, okay, this kid could be an MVP in this league. I truly do believe that.
You think he could be an MVP?
Yes. In the NFL,
Baker Mayfield?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I mean, he played like one.
When we were arguing the other day, I said I would not be surprised if he was in the MVP conversation, you know, in November, December this year, 2021.
I think I saw John Clayton was on Cleveland radio this week and said he thinks Baker Mayfield could be a top 10 quarterback this year. I completely agree with that.
Yeah.
So to people who listened to the episode a while back and heard me say, you know, I would trade Deshaun Watson for Baker Mayfield straight up. Wouldn't do that today, by the way.
But yeah.
But would I even trade Baker Mayfield for Aaron Rodgers straight up right now? I don't even know if I would. Because if look no further than if you want to see a player who is just a headache and honestly a tool, it's Aaron Rodgers. And where does he have a right to gripe about a franchise treating him poorly? If anybody did, it was Deshaun Watson. That franchise actually did him dirty since he came into the league. Aaron Rodgers has played with stud, all-pro, all receivers and running backs literally since he took over the starting role.
Yep. And the thing is now you know, we're talking about Watson and we're talking about Rodgers, and I'm seeing so many similarities to the way they've handled their situations. I mean, both threatened retirement if they didn't get what they wanted. I understand it's a business. I get that whole side of things. But at the end of the day, we're Browns fans, we're football fans. We want to see the game. You know, the business thing, we understand that that's part of it. That's what it is. But we want to watch football. I don't know. I do not want the quarterback leading my team out there saying, well, if I don't get my way, I'll just retire.
Well, see, here, I think there's a huge difference between the way Deshaun Watson and the way Aaron Rodgers handled things.
Yeah, there is.
A huge difference.
The way they handle things or the way they were handled?
The way they handle things. Deshaun Watson put up with this. First of all, where did this come from out of Aaron Rodgers? You literally just won MVP.
Well, he's been griping for years, though.
He literally just won MVP. They fired the coach that you didn't like. They brought in a young offensive-minded coach who turned you into the league MVP. Deshaun Watson was – they traded – I mean, the Texans are awful and didn't have a first or second-round pick this year. You know, they traded his number one receiver. They've had no offensive line for his entire career. No running backs. I mean, did he ever get to play with Arian Foster, or was that before his time?
So well, if he did, it was late career.
Aaron Foster, no, I mean, yeah. nothing against Duke Johnson, but Duke Johnson's not a lead back in this league.
No,
you know. So if there's one of these players who has a reason to complain, it was Deshaun. Aaron Rodgers, in my book, has literally no reason to be upset with the Packers whatsoever.
So I do think that there's something. There is like an attitude thing that follows him around. Like I think, and like we send jokes around. We're like, this guy doesn't talk to his family. Like we laugh about it.
He doesn't. It isn't
a joke. But like for me, there is like, I don't think it's good mojo to have around your team. And I feel like he's the kind of guy that kind of in a locker room, he's a big enough personality to go above your coach, which I don't think you need that, especially with a young coach. I mean, you're seeing that now with Matt LaFleur and Green Bay. My only thing though with Green Bay, and you guys can say, well, that doesn't really do it. All he asked for in 2019 was, hey, go get me a weapon so that I don't just have to throw the ball to Davante Adams a million times, which is working well. Let's just keep that in mind. He does that really well. And there are weapons on that team, but he just said, hey, you know, make it easier for me. And then they went and drafted his backup future quarterback.
Yeah, but
with the first round pick, traded into the first round.
I mean, they got him a stud tight end. They re-signed his running back. I mean, they must not be doing too poorly. He threw 50 touchdowns and only had 5 picks. Right. And they won 13 games and went to the NFC Championship. So maybe they know what they're doing. Maybe they don't need Aaron Rodgers' input. I think we've seen with like the Cavs, look what happens to a franchise when you let the players start making personnel decisions. The Cavs are still the laughingstock of the NBA because LeBron got to sign all of his friends to contracts after they won the championship.
Well, and that's a good point, too, comparing Watson with Rodgers, the whole situation, because they did actually tell Deshaun Watson in Houston that he would have input, and then they didn't give him that input.
Correct.
So I guess I understand your argument from that perspective. Like, somebody tells you, hey, we're going to get your opinion on this, and then they don't. Well, okay, now I'm pretty PO'd about it. Rodgers, there's been no reports that the Packers said, hey, we're going to make sure you have input on this decision or that decision. It's
just
we're running the team, man.
The whole dynamic isn't great. And then I feel like, and I don't know Aaron Rodgers, but I feel like his timing is terrible. I feel like every year it's just bad timing. It's like the day before the draft, you have all these kids there. It's their moment. You know what I mean? Like, they've worked their whole life for this. And I feel like he just kind of just has to sneak in and just be like, by the way, guys, I don't want to be the quarterback of the Green Bay Packers anymore.
He just steals
draft night.
Yeah. He's an egomaniac. I mean, Greg Jennings was a great receiver with him. And him and Greg Jennings Greg Jennings goes on Colin Cowherd's show and basically talks crap about him all the time. Like, they're not friends. And I don't think Aaron Rodgers really has that many friends. I mean, I don't know him personally, but I know his mom doesn't like him. You know, so
I made terrible life decisions, and my mom still loves me. So, we've come a long way. But
and again, the trading. Aaron Rodgers is 37. Before we get out of here, Colin Cowherd did a segment the other day where he said, for the next 10 years, which quarterback would you rather have, Aaron Rodgers or such and such? And he took Aaron Rodgers over Baker Mayfield the next 10 years. 10 years from now, Aaron Rodgers will be 47 years old.
Almost 50. Yeah.
He'll be retired.
I'm like, bro, shut up. Okay, come on. Talk about a troll.
It's just
job.
Like when he did that segment about Baker or the field, and we did a show on that, and it was for the next 5 years, who would you rather have, these quarterbacks or Baker?
Yeah.
And most of them were complete bogus anyway, so.
Yeah, I mean, 10 years, and you'd rather, Aaron Rodgers isn't going to be in the league in 4 years.
I will say this, I think he's got at least 3 or 4 more years in him. I think he's got 3 or 4 more years. If you look at what Tom Brady's done, now Tom Brady's a freak. You know, he's different. But
Aaron Rodgers plays a way different game than Tom Brady.
I agree. But here's my thing. If you can get no garbage Aaron Rodgers and you just get raw talent and you get what he brings to the table, and even like straight up, I think you put him on that Cleveland's roster. And people will make the argument, hey, his playoff record's terrible, blah, blah, blah. He doesn't step up in the big game. I mean, hey, the guy's got a Super Bowl. That's something that we don't have in Cleveland.
True. No, there's no questioning he's one of the most talented quarterbacks ever.
Ever.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Ever, flat out.
I think he's the most effortless thrower of the football I've ever seen. He literally like
flicks his wrist and
flick of the wrist.
Yeah.
And it's on a line.
He doesn't have to set his feet. I mean, he is pretty impressive the way he plays the game.
He's awesome. It's just he's 37. He's a tool. And Baker Mayfield is going to be a top 10 quarterback.
Oh, for sure.
So why deal with the headache?
Yeah.
If you don't have to.
Well, and that's the thing, because I mean, and we can sit here and just like we did with Watson, we can talk straight up, you know, this guy for that guy, but that's never going to be the case. So you would have to mortgage some sort of future to bring in a guy like Rodgers when I'm telling you right now, the guy who can lead Cleveland to a Super Bowl championship is on our roster. He's number six. He's QB1. He is a dog.
Do we think it's strange, though, that like how long ago was the Deshaun Watson stuff? Like
A couple months ago.
Mm-hmm.
Is it strange that a couple months ago, Cleveland fans made the argument, hey, let's go get Deshaun Watson, and now today, I literally think Aaron Rodgers is a better talent than Deshaun Watson, and you're seeing Cleveland fans come to Baker Mayfield's defense and say, hey, he's our guy. This is I'm not the only one. It's not like I'm just the crazy loyal to the soil guy. You're seeing Cleveland fans literally unite on it and say, hey, we don't want Aaron Rodgers, which is kind of crazy.
I just said I didn't want Aaron Rodgers.
It's crazy to me. I know that, you know, we talk about it, but it's...
And don't get me wrong. If something crazy happened and Aaron Rodgers was on the Browns, I think he would be very good.
Oh, yes.
That being said, I'm not trading for him.
No, right. And I think if you had Baker Mayfield on the Green Bay Packers, he would be very good. I think he would run that offense well.
It's kind of a similar offense. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, they all come from like that Shanahan style of offense. Yeah. All right, well, I just want to get our quick thoughts on that. I wish Zach would have been here. What do you think, Zach?
Oh, okay. Cool. Yeah, cool.
So, but, you know, I just want to get some quick thoughts on that. You know, let us know what you guys think. You know, I think overwhelmingly Browns fans, they want Baker Mayfield to be the guy. We're excited to see him play this year.
Man, I cannot freaking wait.
Yeah.
Hopefully I didn't hurt Aaron Rodgers' feelings when I called him a tool.
He won't talk to you anyway.
Yeah. I'll be at your mom's house if you want to talk.